Well, here we go on day four of our series of overcoming obstacles. And today we're going to be tackling the courage in the face of fear. And we're going to be using a familiar passage here in Joshua 1:9. And we're going to look at it. So this is a conversation between Joshua and God, and how he encouraged, God encouraged Joshua. And it says, take courage. And as we take courage, knowing that God is with you wherever you go, let go of the fear and trust in his presence and protection as you confront obstacles with boldness and with faith. So in Joshua 1:9, God reassures Joshua of his continual presence and commands him to be strong and courageous in the face of fear. And this verse is not only a message to Joshua, but to all of us believers, and reminding us that we can confront our fears with confidence because God is always with us. So the first practical application of courage in the face of fear is to actively trust in God's presence. This means consciously acknowledging that God is with you in every situation, no matter how challenging or intimidating it might seem. You see, Joshua had Moses to look to, and now it was up to him. So remind yourself of his promises, and in Joshua 1:9, and draw strength from these assurances that you are never alone. So by cultivating a deep trust in God's presence, you can face your fears with boldness and confidence. You see, courage is not the absence of fear, but the willingness to act in spite of it. So therefore, another application is to confront your fears with faithful action. Instead of allowing fear to paralyze you, take intentional steps forward, relying on God's strength and guidance, whether it's pursuing a new opportunity or speaking up for what is right, or facing a daunting challenge. You need to choose to trust in God's promises and to act with boldness and in faith. So as you step out into obedience, you will experience God's provision and see his faithfulness manifest into your life. So by applying these principles of trusting God's presence and confronting fear with a faithful action, you can cultivate a spirit of courage that enables you to overcome any obstacles or challenges that you may encounter. So as you lean in on God's strength today and his guidance, may you find courage and confidence to walk boldly in the path that he has set out for you. You see, Joshua had a choice. He could either keep things as they were, or he could listen to what God was saying to him to be strong and confident, and then move into the new promises that are in his life. So with our obstacles, we need to be the same. We need to not rely on what we knew, but actually to look at what we're being asked to do to go into the new promise. So I hope this has helped you today, and I look forward to sharing with you tomorrow as we carry on with this series, Overcoming Obstacles.